Right, okay, guys, next up, we've got Kid Dynamite himself, Mark Heffron, who's 13-0, 11 knockouts, 8 in the first round. And listen, we've seen a beautiful knockout there, John. Do you think we're going to be seeing something like that again with Mark Heffron?
Yeah, Mark's going to have to go some to match that, isn't he? That was crisp and clean. Mark tends to get done a bit more wild, rugged and powerful, doesn't he? As we spoke earlier, Bo, he's been working on rationing his power, working behind his jab and boxing more. Let's see if we see any signs of that tonight.
Now, back in the days where Prince Nassim Hamad used to fight, when Oscar Suarez altered his style a little bit to make him more of an orthodox boxer, he actually lost a little bit. Do you think there's a danger of actually changing Mark Heffron? Do you want to keep him? Do you think we should keep him wild or what?
I think you've got. That's what makes Mark Heffron, isn't it? We don't want him to change too much. We want him to be aggressive. We want him to be powerful. We want him to be exciting. We want to be in wild brawls. You know, if you look down the Box Nation list, there's Jamie Cox, there's Anthony Leach. Fantastic future fights, future brawls. Yeah. But maybe Heffron's just got to show us a little bit more tonight.
Okay, now there is rumours that he may also be trying to come down to middleweight from the 168-pound division. Do you think that's a wise move for him, sort of from a marketing standpoint and from getting in the mix with different fights?
Yeah, super middleweight division's absolutely packed, isn't it? Opportunities are going to be hard to come by. Down at middleweight, the way seems a little more clear, like we saw Tommy Langford and Sam Sheedy fight for a British title, for his path to the British middleweight title. If Mark can do it and it doesn't take too much away from him, I think he should.
Okay, what are the keys then, the keys to victory for Mark Heffron tonight?
Oh, keys to victory for Mark Heffron are simple, aren't they? Land your power shots.
Yeah.
I think if we're talking about keys to survival for Mr. Hoskin Gomez, Avoid the power shots. I think it's a very simple fight to call this one.
Listen, you heard it there. Avoid the power shots. Let's see if he can do it. We're going to pass over to the commentators, Barkery Jammeh, Jammeh Albrecht. Over to you, Barks.
Okay, thanks, Aki. Thanks, John. Just talking myself for there. We don't need to echo that. We've been over that. Okay, we're going to come up soon with Mark Heffron. Yeah, okay. I think we're going to go over to our MC now, who's going to introduce the main event of the evening. It's Mark Heffron against Christian Hoskin Gomez. This is Black Flash Promotions on BritishBoxers.co.uk.
Time to strap yourselves in, stiffen the sinews, and summon the blood as we begin the main event, Gomez versus Heffron! And it's time to meet the boxers making his way to the blue corner. From Cadiz, Spain, via Plymouth, England, it's Christian Hoskin Gomez! And it's time to meet his opponent, making his way to the red corner, from Oldham, England, it's Kid Dynamite, Mark Heffron!
Ready or not, here I come, you can't hide, gonna find you. And take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and make you want me.
Now that I escape, sleep, walk, or wake. Yeah. Those who correlate know the world ain't picked. Jail bars ain't golden gates. Those who fake, they break. When they meet their 400-pound mate, if I could rule the world, everyone would have a gun. And together, of course, we get the up and on their horse. Kick around, drinking moonshine. I pour a sip on the concrete for the deceased, but no, don't weep. Why Clef's in a state of sleep, thinking about the robbery that I did last week. Money in the bag, banker look like a dragon.
Black Flash Promotions, in association with BritishBoxers.co.uk, proudly bring you bout number 4 of this evening, and it's proudly sponsored by Andrew Cowie Construction, the Manchester Institute for Health and Performance, and Nicholas Cable Tech. This is a middleweight contest scheduled for 6 3-minute rounds of boxing. And for the main event, it's time to meet the boxers. Standing in the blue corner, weighing in at 11 stone, 12 pounds and 2 ounces. In this, his 28th professional contest of his career, wearing the black shorts, hailing from Cadiz, Spain, via Plymouth, England, it's Christian Hoskin Gomez! And his opponent, standing in the red corner, weighing in at 11 stone, 13 pounds and 8 ounces, with 13 victories, with 11 by way of stoppage, in this, his 14th contest of his professional career, from Oldham, England, the undefeated Mark Kid Dynamite Heffron.
You both know the rules, so let's just have a good clean fight, okay? Most of all, remember to defend yourselves at all times, all right? Touch gloves, keep it clean.
Okay, time for the main event. Mark, Kid Dynamite Heffron.
Second down.
Against Bravo. Christian Hoskin Gomez. Exciting fighter.
Yeah, I think he summed it up perfectly. Yeah. Gomez's only strategy should be to stay away from the bombs.
Yeah. Easier said than done. I remember Mark Heffron when he first burst onto the scene, when he was with Gallagher's gym for a while, wasn't he, as a welterweight. And I remember him then, he's talking probably 2011, something like that. And even then, as a welterweight, you know, people were like, this kid's
scary power.
Yeah, you know.
Gomez is brave, isn't he?
He's coming, landed a nice body shot of his own, did Gomez then. And again.
Maybe trying to earn Heffron's respect. I don't think that's going to cut much ice, so as soon as he lets them hands down, it might be good night, but we'll see what his chin's like.
Yeah.
He does do that a lot, Heffron. He tends to neglect the jab at times. It would be nice to see him work that. Particularly at a higher level, you know, he'd need to work behind the jab and perhaps box, because there are going to be people that are still going to be standing there when he launches shots. Yeah.
As we said, though, with having that knockout ratio, it's easy to kind of go back to know what you're best.
Yeah, you fall in love. In love with your power, as they say.
Exactly. Yeah. They've all done it. Nigel Benn a lot.
Nazim Hamed.
Yeah. Managed by Kevin Marie. Trained by Kevin Marie.
Yeah, he's good.
Nice uppercut from Gomez. Switch to southpaw for a minute. As Heffron
pouring the jab out, maybe using it as a range finder. Gomez looking really game. He's not come here to just lay down.
No, good left up from Gomez. You know, he's tasted a few shots as well, Gomez, and it's not put him off yet.
No. Might be mad.
Nice body shot again from Gomez. Right to the body.
Tickled the ribs out.
Yep.
Your shots up, man.
Nice body shot from Heffron. A quite impressed with Gomez, though, to be fair. He's you know, he's in there and he's come up fight. But that was a good left. Good left up from
there.
And again. This is where he does his best work. And another left. Gomez is still in there, but he's rocked him there and he's down.
Brave decision. Well, not a decision. He fell to his knees there, understandably. He's got a look of a man who's a little bit, you know, what the hell was that? Looking down at his feet.
Had a quick look to the corner as well, yeah. Then just to...
Point
to
of contemplation, perhaps.
Yeah, what do we do here? I think
what the hell am I doing here?
Yeah, saved by the bell there. Nearly took it to nine stoppages he's in the first round.
He's got the minerals, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But fair play to him, he got up. But if there's any, if that starts to taste the things to come, it's not going to last very much longer.
I think he's in a bit of a lose-lose situation because if he throws back, he's open to a counter.
Yeah.
And we've seen, obviously, he's fallen on the floor. He's not happy with the power. Maybe steaming in, keeping the hands up, doing a bit of the Joe Gallagher thing, like you use it against him.
Yeah. As we said earlier on as well, though, there's a lot of talk around Mark Heffron at the moment. He's just signed a big deal with Frank Warren and Box Nation. It's a three-year contract. I think it's four fights a year. And he's actually on the Terry Flanagan bill, the undercard, along with Ayres Alford as well. So
good platform for him, especially with the BT deal coming as well. Massive exposure for these fighters. Exciting times. As we say that, Gomez steaming straight into the task. He's got to be lauded for his bravery.
Yeah, right to the body.
And the referee's jumped in. Waving the towel, the referee's jumped in.
Second round stoppage.
It's quite refreshing to see him on his feet.
Yeah, the corner then, they knew. There was only one way that was going to go.
Yeah.
Fantastic performance again from Mark Heffron.
I'd really like to sort of respect Gomez there, though. You know, he's still standing. He had his hands up and he didn't give up, did he?
No, he went out on his shield. It brings a good support as well. He's got a good following, Mark Heffron. I think Mark Heffron, like Zelford, it's all there in his hands. You know, he's got the whole package. Good looking lad. Great record.
I'd just like to see him use the jab a little bit more.
Yeah, he's still learning. He's still work in progress. Yeah, definitely.
Commit to his boxing. You know, especially as he moves up, it might be more durable opponents out there. But you can't complain at a man who's stopping people with the regularity of the ears. You know, I'm just picky.
Just saluting his fans there as well. The crowd, just looking out back at the top of the arena there is quite a few in.
Please, boxers, to the centre of the ring.
Quite hard. There's quite a lot I wanted to talk about tonight with Lyndon, Zelfa and Mark. We didn't really get a chance to.
I think that's the one downside about the short bill. But
ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause please for both of our professional boxers. Please put your hands together. Timekeeper at ringside, Mr. Gary Grennan, records an official time of 33 seconds of round two as the official end of the contest. In his professional opinion, Mr. Michael Alexander, our referee, found Christian Hoskin Gomez in no position to continue. Therefore, our winner is, and still undefeated, the Kid Dynamite, Mark Heffron!
Yeah, Kid Dynamite moves to 14-0, 12 KOs, 10 in the first two rounds. Fantastic, as we said, you know, he's got it all. I just want to give a big shout out on the Twitter, on the hashtag BBTV Live to Radiant Physio, who's just put great coverage of Mark Heffron and Zelfa Barrett, so obviously enjoyed it. We're going to go across to Ake and John Evans at the back of the stage.
Thank you, guys. Well, Kid Dynamite lived up to his name there, John.
Yeah, it's a devastating finish, wasn't it? Once Mark smelt blood, he was on Hoskins Gomez there. Hoskins Gomez is a tough guy. He's just recently gave Anthony Leek four rounds on his debut, on Leckie's debut.
Yeah, yeah.
Tough opponent. Mark just, once he... Sorry, just got Lyndon Harper ducking under the camera there.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner.
Once Mark found his range, oh, he was on him.
Mark,
now, I mean, when he threw straight shots, he actually looked more effective. A little bit wild at times, you think?
Yeah, that's Mark, though. Like we said before, the last thing we want Mark to do is tone down his style too much and lose that raw aggressiveness that he's got. You could have tidied up a hell of a lot about that tonight, couldn't you, if it was raw edges all over the place? But he still got the job done.
Absolutely. And you know what? He's one of them fighters that he almost punches through the opponent's gloves. Even if they're guarding, he actually punches through. And there's very few fighters that have that amount of power.
He does, yeah. It's like, it's very rare power, isn't it? A lot of people can hurt opponents, but to be able to consistently land power shots like that and take somebody, a durable opponent, out, it's just another level power. Now we've got to see if he can carry that power up to another level and take on like a more respected opponent with maybe a winning record next time out.
Well, looking forward to some of those opponents that he could potentially get in there with, do you see him being a major force in the 168-pound division or even the 160-pound division?
Yeah, I'd like to see him in the mix at middleweight. The key now is matching him well. Obviously, he signed the Box Nation deal. He's going to fight on April the 8th, isn't he, at Manchester Arena. A good eight-round opponent there, a solid test. Someone who can maybe take him a few rounds and so we can see a little bit more what Mark's got to offer. It's going to be an exciting journey, though, while it goes.
Oh, amen. It's going to be exciting. And the thing is, he's brings a massive crowd with him. I mean, he can't even get round here at the minute because there's so many people, you know, sort of want to take pictures with him and stop him and everything. Again, that's probably down to his exciting nature, isn't it?
It does, yeah. It's an exciting fight to watch. Also, the Heffrons are a very popular family in Oldham. It looks like most of Yorkshire Street and Edgerton Street have turned up here tonight. Family got a big reputation, always been popular. Ronnie had a decent following when he was fighting, and people will follow exciting fighters. As we say, once momentum starts building, people just keep on jumping, don't they? And there seems to be a lot of people jumping on Mark Heffron's bandwagon at the moment.
Absolutely. Now, you mentioned something a bit earlier about when someone actually does take his power and stand up to it, that's when we're going to really find out a lot more about Mark Heffron, isn't it?
It is. And that's where, as you said before, Pat's been working on trying to get him to box behind his jab a little bit more and calm down. Once someone does stand up to him, we're going to have to see exactly what Mark's got. He was blown a little bit there after the first round. Maybe that was because he expended so much energy. Let's see if that proves to be an issue when he's fighting four and five rounds.
Absolutely. And one thing about Mark Heffron, though, is that he's actually fought all around the world. He's fought in places like Poland, Ireland, the Netherlands, Spain. So he's not afraid. You know, he's actually, in a way, done the hard yards to get to where he is now.
Yes, he's done the hard yards, and I'm sure he's been hard tested in the gym. Maybe that's a key now for Mark. Maybe the key's going to come in sparring. Maybe they're not going to put him into a 50-50 fight before it's worth for a meaningful title. Maybe Mark's learning's going to have to come in the gym. I know over at the Finest Gym, we're looking at getting Anthony Leek some tough sparring to see what he is made of and see what it's like in a tough fight. Maybe that's what Pat should be looking at for Mark now.
Yeah, cool. And he's actually, he's rumoured to be coming down in weight to 160 pounds. Do you actually feel he'll be better in the middleweight, suited for a middleweight division or the super middleweight division, given his frame and size?
Frame and size, he looks like a 12-stone man. Whether he can actually boil himself down to middleweight remains to be seen. I certainly don't think he's going to lose his power at either weight class. If he's super middleweight, he's certainly going to have super middleweight power. That power's going to be even more devastating at middleweight.
Well, talking of Kid Dynamite, here he is himself, Mark Heffron in the house.
Yeah.
Mark, firstly, you've got through your sea of friends and fans there.
Yeah.
How do you feel after that performance?
Yeah, I feel good. It was a good performance. Fucking tough guy, innit? Jesus Christ, I didn't think he was going to stop, but thought it was, I was going to go the distance. Well, I was lucky to go the distance. I trained for it anyway, so I knew I was fit enough. But yeah, I got a good stoppage there, and I enjoyed it, and thanks to all my fans coming as well.
Hoskins Gomez is a tough guy, Mark.
Yeah.
You know, he took Leek four rounds,
yeah.
Gave Leek a good foot.
Yeah.
Once you hurt him there, you smelt blood, you were on him.
Anthony Leek's a fucking a top prospect, and yeah, he took him the distance, you know. I got him out there, was it two rounds, wasn't it? I got him out within two rounds, and yeah, it was tough, really tough. I enjoyed it as well. My other fights, when I've been in the ring, I've not fought, and in that ring then, it felt like a spar, do you know what I mean? It felt like a spar, and every shot, I knew what I was throwing, do you know what I mean? I was planning my shots.
Mark, was it a bit of a change to see someone actually try and stand and trade with you? Because normally you're used to people feeling your power a bit, and then going on the back foot. He actually tried to stand and trade a bit with you, didn't he?
Yeah, well, he's... there's not many people that will get in there and stand and trade with my power and stuff. I mean, but yeah, he did. And he, obviously he didn't stay, but he took some good shots.
You know, it's interesting then you said you were picking your shots and you could feel it more. Is that down to what Pat's been doing, just getting you to rein it in a bit, calm down a little bit and make your power tell?
Yeah, that's one of Pat's main things, thinking on your shots and turning your shots in. If you don't turn a shot in on the pads with Pat, you can take up to fucking, you can be in there for 10 hours until you get the shot right, do you know what I mean? And when you do get it right, you've got to get it right another 10 times after that. You won't just let you get it right once and then that's it. It's you get it right and you've got to get it right another 10 times, do you know what I mean? So I'm picking my shots a lot better now and yeah, I'm enjoying it.
And of course, Mark, you're next out on a massive bill in Manchester on the 8th of April. Tell us about your thoughts going up onto that massive show.
Yeah, I'm absolutely over the moon. Massive, massive thank you to Frank Warren for putting me on that show. It's a dream come true to get on Frank Warren's shows. From being a little kid growing up, I've watched him. I've watched Frank Warren and my brother Ronnie was with Frank Warren. Do you know what I mean? And obviously, when I was with another manager, I used to always think to myself, I wish I was fighting under Frank Warren. Do you know what I mean? And yeah, and that it's come true now. Do you know what I mean? And it's happening. It don't feel real, but it's happening.
Fantastic. Well, Mark, listen, we wish you the best. You move onwards to 14-0 with 12 stoppages, 8 in the first round. And listen, John and I were just saying before, we're really going to enjoy this ride, man. Yeah. All the best to you.
Thank you.
Mark Heffron, guys, watch out.
Thank you.
Well, what can I say, guys? It's been a brilliant night of boxing. 4 hot prospects. And just review it very quickly. Jack Flatley, solid 4-round win. Really good. We had Lyndon Arthur looking at his devastating best, throwing those long levered backhand shots. We've had Zelfa with that beautiful catch and shoot, blocked it through the left hook, absolutely fantastic. And of course there, Mark Heffron in an exciting fight. We're going to bring back John Evans in here. Here he is. John, what a show tonight.
Yeah, really good. I think each of the lads showed something different, didn't they? Yeah. We saw Jack Flatley having an opponent throwing shots back at him, kept his cool and composure. Lyndon Arthur showed that he can take people out at light heavyweight. We might not have thought much about his opponent. I think his heart contributed to his defeat as much as
and his knee.
Zelfa, little bit wild at times, but he showed that he's got that power again. Beautiful technique as well to land that left hook. And then Mark Heffron doing what he does best, just bludgeoning someone.
Yeah, and John, I'm going to put you on the spot, but I know you're used to it because you're a professional. Highlight of the night.
Highlight of the night for me was the technique on Zelfa's catch and shoot.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm biased towards Zelfa because I always do talk about him a lot, but it takes a certain level of fight to have the confidence to pull that off in the middle of battle.
No, it was sublime. And each one of those fighters has said they love fighting here at the small hall. It might be difficult to get them into the big arenas now. They love it so much.
Oh, the Middleton Arena's being drowned out by a bit of dusty Springfield. The Middleton Arena's a special place. Zelfa's come from the dirt to the diamonds, as he likes to say. It's a bit of a shame it's come to an end of an era. Maybe Lyndon can carry it on.
Fantastic. Listen, John, it's been great having you here, chatting with you today. We've seen 4 hot prospects on display at the Black Flash promotion show, aired live on BBTV. Listen, guys, we hope you'd enjoyed it. From John and from myself, Aki Karim, we're out of here. Power!